Premier Jay Weatherill has dispatched another minister, effectively firing underperforming MP Russell Wortley. The move takes the number of cabinet departures for the week to three, with a fourth expected by Monday. With more, political reporter James Wakeland's live in the newsroom. James.
Beck, it's extremely clear that Jay Weatherill now has factional support to do the reshuffle he wants. Perhaps that's best shown by a phone call he made to Russell Wortley, where he told him he didn't think he was up to being part of his new cabinet. In just 35 seconds, Jay Weatherill ended the cabinet career of Russell Wortley, the gaffe-prone local government and industrial relations minister, deciding not to fight the Premier's decision to axe him.
I don't want this to be turned into a Jay Weatherill versus Russell Wortley or the factions versus Jay Weatherill.
It must have been a difficult decision for him, but I greatly respect what he's done.
Mr. Wortley's forced resignation follows the retirements of John Hill and Patrick Conlon on Tuesday. A fourth minister, more than likely Paul Kiker, is expected to go soon.
I don't know. You must speak to Paul Kiker on that.
The Deputy Premier letting slip he's already counting on another farewell.
If you start with a certain number and you deduct four, you do create vacancies.
One willing applicant, Parliamentary Secretary Leon Bignall.
If I'm asked to, I'd get in there and do a good job. So, but, you know, it's up to Jay and we'll just wait and see what happens in the next few days.
Lisa Vlahos is firming as the other replacement, with two vacancies to go unfilled as Premier Jay Weatherill cuts his cabinet from 15 to 13.
We've given Jay Weatherill basically the keys to the car. He is our leader. He is doing a very good job at the moment under very trying circumstances.
Beck, this reshuffle should all be finalised on Monday as part of a caucus meeting, which should really just be a rubber stamp of the team that Jay Weatherill wants to take to the 2014 election. The great question that mark, though, remains on the future of Water Minister Paul Kiker. Beck?
Thank you, James.